The story dates back about 12 years ago. My dad was the original owner of the car before me. We were looking for a 202 BMW. We were finding it hard to get a good used one. So then suddenly my dad said that why not we find an E30 M3? And it was the best decision in my life. Than the normal E30 because of its arches. That's one of the most obvious outlook of the car. To me, to be honest, it's not the front part that I like the most. It's actually the back part. So whenever I park the car, I usually go towards the back and have a look at the rear quarter panel. It's exquisite. It's beautiful. What's the difference between the normal E30 and the E30 M3 is the way it moves in the corners, the way it balances the chassis and whatnot. I think that's the most beautiful thing about the car. So whenever you go through like corners, you would literally smile. And going back to your question about the engine, so the car doesn't have the original S14. The car had an M50 B25 engine that was stroked to 3.2 using a higher stroke kit. Story was the S14 engine blew at the track day, and the previous owner decided that he wanted to put the E36 engine instead because it was a cheaper option for him. After I bought the car, I thought to myself that this is an M car, it should have an M engine as well. So this is a bit crazy because I bought another car just to get its engine and the gearbox, and I swapped it and sold off that car, and the S50 B32 engine from the E36 M3 Evo is now sitting in my E30 M3. We were fortunate enough to own nice cars, and I think over the years what happened was I developed this love for machines. So I like to see how these nuts and bolts contributes to the overall performance of a car or workings of a car. I've gone into like playing Tamiya, racing Tamiyas when I was in secondary school, up to when I'm older, owning a car and maintaining it myself. I think this car, what it meant to me and my dad was it kept us a bit closer, because with cars you get this cool relationship whereby whenever there's a weekend or the drive, we get together and we go up to Genting or Uluyam or whatnot. So that's one of my fondest memories with the car. If you want to own an older BMW, get to know your cars first. Understand the basic knowledge of cars, then you would understand how cars work. Another advice that I would give is take your time in searching for a car. The thing about owning a car is always about the community as well. People do support you, people answer questions. If you have any issues, people will come up and help you. That's where the bonus of owning a BMW is. I want to share that memory with my kids. Whenever I go in the car with my daughter, she would like, "Daddy, drive faster."